Sa wagas, humarap na sa kamara si dating presidential spokesperson Harry Roque at inilantadang umano'y mga katiwalian sa administrasyon ni Pangulong Cotting Jr. Matagal nang inaabangan ng publiko ang pagkakataong ito at hindi winigo ni Roque ang mga naghihintay. Sa kanyang pahayag, ibinahagi niya ang ilang insidente ng korupsyon na anya'y nagaganap sa loob ng pamahalaan, bagay na nagdulot ng malalim na usapan sa miyembro ng kamara. Sa kaniyang testimonya, binigyan din ni Roque ang ilang mga proyekto at kontratang pinasok ng administrasyon na umano'y puno ng anomalya. Ayon kay Roque, ilan sa mga kontratang ito ay nagkaroon ng overpricing at pag-prioritize sa mga kumpanyang malapit sa opisyal ng pamahalaan. Sa kabila ng mga banta at panggigipit, nagpahayag si Roque na kinakailangan niyang isiwalat ang mga impormasyong ito para sa kapakanan ng bayan. Kaagad namang nag-react ang mga mambabatas at ilang mga opisyal ng gobyerno sa mga ibinigay ni Roque. Habang may mga nananawagan ng mga susing imbisigasyon, mayroon ding namang nagdududa sa motibo ng dating tagapagsalita. Sa kabila ng reaksyong malinaw na ang pahayag ni Roque ay nagdulot ng panibagong yugto sa usapin ng katiwalian sa administrasyon ni Pangulong Cotting. Ang tanong ng marami ngayon ay kung ano ang magiging susunod na hakbang ng pamahalaan at ng mga kinauukulan. Well, ito nga ang balitang ating pagkakatutukan. Ngunit bagong lahat, siguraduhin mag-subscribe at i-hit ang notification bell para tuloy-tuloy ang pagtutok mo sa mga bago at nagbabagang balita dito sa Bangon Pinas.
Chief.
Point of inquiry only.
Yes, Congresswoman Luistro, please.
With the indulgence of Deputy Speaker Albano, did we reserve copy of all those 402 illegal POGOs? Did we reserve copy for the committee?
Of course, we have. If you want a copy, we will be sending you the hard copy. We have the copies of that.
Yes, Mr. Chair, and during the previous hearings, I was made to understand that we will look into the incorporators as well.
Yes, the incorporators are all in the back of this chairman.
Okay.
So if you wanted to see the incorporators of the 402 that was submitted by the SEC, it's all behind us.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Chair.
For your information, I have looked through all those documents. And more of the incorporators, lahat, laging may dalawang Chinese.
I yield to the wisdom of the chair.
All of them.
Thank you.
Sige, go ahead, Congressman.
Thank you for giving me the time.
Albano,
I just had to bring the Senate President and the Chief Legal Counsel of the President and Enrile outside. My remaining time is short. I would just like to ask the PAOC, is Mr. Sir Casio here? If not, Yusek Gilbert Cruz, I think. Is Mr. Casio here? Yusek Gilbert Cruz?
Wala po, sir. He's attending another officer.
Yes. Well, first, I laud the operations and your, of course, you know, functions as the PAOC to get rid of all these illegal gamblings and corruption in the country. But isang question lang po, siguro nagkaroon kayo ng mga miscommunication because I have here an executive order number 13 dated February 2, 2017, and it says strengthening the fight against illegal gambling, etc., etc., etc. And in here it says at section 4, paragraph 2, all government agencies and authorities such as PAGCOR, CESA, AFAB, APECO, etc., are hereby directed to fully cooperate with and tender their assistance to the Office of the President and its duly authorized representative in the performance of the tasks and functions herein provided. But your spokesperson, Mr. Casio, has made a statement linking that there were POGOs in CESA, which was refuted by no less than the CESA Secretary Katrina Ponce Enrile. So I'm wondering, is there a breakdown in communication because this EO has ordered you and has ordered CESA to communicate with you, and I'm asking the question why And where did Mr. Casio get the statements that there are pogos in CESA?
Nako, Chrissy Brooks, naglaga na!
We will check on that, Your Honor. As to the statement made by Director Casio, I'll probably ask him or make him to provide us a report as to the information na kung saan po nanggaling yung if he really made that statement, sir.
Yes, please provide that information as soon as possible. And I would like to request, being that you are the Undersecretary of PAOC, that with this executive order, you can easily ask questions and they will cooperate because these are all under the office of the president. And it would have been better for you to have done that so that hindi naman mapahiya yung mga ibang agencies dito na hindi naman kasama dito sa ating mga investigation. Would you agree?
Yes, sir. I fully agree with that, sir. Actually, that is the direction of the PAOC right now, sir. We're trying to connect, sir, with those agencies, sir, na binanggit mo. So as not to commit the mistake na nangyari before, sir.
Opo. And if indeed Mr. Casio has linked CESA with these illegal POGOs, I would like to ask for you to ask him to make a formal apology and submit it to this body and also to report it to the media so that mawala naman yung batikos dito sa aming CESA na importante po sa aming rehiyon ng Region 2.
Yes, sir. As to the apology, sir, opo, we will do that. But if ever, sir, we have this intel report, I just give it personally to you, sir.
Yes, please submit to our chairperson's confidential.
Yes,
para magkaroon kami ng investigation tungkol dito.
Alam ko po kasi, sir, we have we have intel reports. I'll just give it to you in sa office niyo siguro, sir.
Yeah. Marami pong salamat.
Thank you, sir.
With that, may I ask the chair for leave already?
Okay. Thank you, Deputy Speaker Albano.
Hello, hello! Laglaga
before
na, guys!
Proceed,
Marie!
I'd like to acknowledge Representative Patrick Michael Vargas.
Ayan po, si Atty. Harap po kayo, guys. Next lumantad sa camera.
Yes, Representative
po si Enrile.
Johnny Benitez.
Ano ginagawa
Benitez
ni Enrile dyan?
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I have two matters rather to discuss in this committee. The first one, Mr. Chair, I'd like to reiterate my firm position that this committee should issue a subpoena to compel Ms. Cassandra Leong to attend this hearing.
Ayan na, ayan na!
I have in my possession documents submitted by the Bureau of Immigration showing that Ms. Cassandra Leong has been going in and out of the country since 2008. So that would mean that Ms. Leong has been conducting business activities in the country for the past 16 years. And if you will recall, a month ago, the authorities raided the Pogo compound in Pampanga, and it was found out that there were traces of evidence that Ms. Leong owned or resided in one of these buildings. So therefore, Mr. Our Chair, I would surmise that this Ms. Leong occupies a very high position in the hierarchy of these illegal POGOs. So that, Mr. Chair, it is imperative that we compel Ms. Leong to attend this by issuing a subpoena. Yun po ang isang matter that I would like to discuss. Now, the second matter that I'd like to discuss, Mr. Chair, is with regards to the recent reports that two Chinese nationals were apprehended in Baguio City, and supposedly these two Chinese nationals are persons of interest regarding exactly the matter of this hearing. So may I know from Yusek Gilbert Cruz, kung kayo po ba ang nag-conduct ng raid and apprehension dun sa Baguio?
Wait, for a while. Congressman.
Yes, I've Vice got Chairperson, the
Wait. Vice Chairman Pimentel, I think you have a first motion.
No, it was not a motion. It was a suggestion. It was a recommendation because we cannot pass this subpoena or contempt order without the quorum.
No, we have a quorum.
Ah, we do?
Yeah, we do have a quorum.
We do have a quorum. Then, Mr. Chair, let me go back to my first matter.
Yes,
I move that we issue a subpoena to Ms. Leong, or rather, to make it more purpose, I move to cite for contempt Ms. Leong.
Naku, contempt na naman.
Okay.
Ano ba yan?
Before we act on the motion of Vice Chairperson Johnny Pimentel, the chair would like to recognize first Congressman Chairman Paduano. Go ahead.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Anyway, just to clarify our internal rules and protocols with regards to contempt, we cannot contempt in my own personal understanding of our rules, Mr. Chairman. We cannot contempt a resource speaker without first issuing a subpoena at the testificandum. So we should be strict on giving due process. But of course, question of not attending hearing without legal excuse, that will be the violation later, and that will be the basis for us to cite Ong if he will not be present in the next hearing, if we move and vote in favor of the motion of the Congressman Pimentel with regards to issuance of subpoena to Ms. Ong.
No, we have invited Cassandra Leong twice, and in accordance with our rules and the practice of this house is on the third time that we have invited the resource persons without any explanation, Ashoka's order will be in order. So,
Mr. Chair,
so I think the subpoena is the proper order that this committee should issue to her. So if it will be okay with the Vice Chairman Pimentel.
Go ahead. So that everyone will be clarified, Mr. Chair. Under Section 11 of our House Rules, the committee may punish any person for contempt by a vote of 2/3 of the members present, there being a quorum. The following shall be grounds. 1. Refusal without legal excuse to obey summons. It is very clear we have already issued 2 invitations to Ms. Leong, and she has no even, she did not even reply. There is no legal excuse. And this falls within Section A of Section 11.
Puro la content.
So bakit pa natin patatagalin ito? Eh, we will know very well, kahit mag-issue pa tayo ng show cause order yan, kahit 3 show cause order pang issue natin, hindi sisipot yung si Leo.
Yes.
Why we have to go to the long route when we can issue already to cite her for contempt?
Sige.
Very clear na naman po sa Section 11.
We
Section
understand
A.
The emotion of yes. The next governor.
Kasi, because, Mr.
But for the information of
itong
Vice
Chair,
wait, Mr. Vice Chairman. For the information of the Vice Chairperson, the reason why we need to issue a subpoena order first because we don't have a 2/3 members who are present today.
But, okay, if that is the pleasure of the body, Mr. Chair,
yes.
Then I withdraw my motion. Instead, I move that we issue a subpoena
yes.
to Ms. Cassandra Leong. So yeah, move, Mr.
Yeah, okay.
Chair.
So there's a motion by Vice Chairman Johnny Pimentel to issue a subpoena to Ms. Cassandra Leong. Is there a second motion?
I second the motion.
There's a second motion. Any objection? Hearing none, the said motion is now approved.
Puro lang kung
okay. Can I proceed, Mr. Chair? Because I have 2 matters. I said, I have 2 matters.
Wait first.
Mr. Chair, I would like to thank Representative Flores because we switched.
Ah, you switched.
Time slot.
And also with Congressman Bosita? Bosita will be the first interpellator.
Minority.
And then the majority. So if
he will... The one who was
recognized. Wait. if you will allow, Congressman Busita will allow it to be for you to be the first interpellator, then I will recognize you. Okay, Congressman, Vice Chairman,
thank you. You are now recognized. Busita, I'm adamant because I have another hearing sa legislative franchise at 1 p.m. and there is a very important matter to approve. Now anyway, my second matter, I'll just be very brief. Again, may I reiterate my previous question to Yusek Gilbert Cruz, whether yung grupo ba ninyo ang nag-apprehend doon sa two Chinese nationals in Baguio?
Yes, Your Honor. It's with the Bureau of Immigration and regional offices of Cordillera, CIDG, and the Anti-Cybercrime Group of Cordillera.
Mr. Chair, pero kayo pong lead agency noon, ano?
Yes, sir.
Okay, can you, for clarification purposes, sino po ba itong dalawang Chinese national na nahuli ninyo doon?
Yung dalawang Chinese... wait, sir, I'll just get my records. Yung dalawang Chinese nationals po doon, sir, is the female one is Wan Keeping, who arrived in the country on July 17, 2024 with and another one, sir, is a male Chinese national who found to be undocumented, and later he introduced himself as a Cambodian, sir, by the name of Kun Mowern. And later on, sir, we found out na siya po ay isang fugitive wanted for prosecution under an Interpol red notice, and his real name, sir, is Mr. Sun Li Ming, who escaped to the Philippines and has introduced himself as Kun Mowern, a Cambodian national. He has been identified as an IT consultant responsible for the creation of some IT platforms being used by scam firms in the country. He was apprehended by the Bureau of Immigration and the PAOK last July 27, 2024, sir, at Pinewood Subdivision, Tuba, Banguet.
So to just clarify, Mr. Chair, so hindi pala dalawang Chinese national. Isang Chinese and then isang Cambodian.
He introduced himself as a Cambodian, sir, but later on, sir, we found out na siya po ay isang Chinese national, fugitive Chinese national.
Okay. Walang problema dun sa isa, no? Yung nagko-claim na Cambodian national siya. Very clear naman na fugitive yun.
Apo.
What about the other one? Ano naman ang kasalanan nun?
Ang kinaso po natin doon is for her harboring this criminal, sir.
So, are these two involved doon sa, connected ba ito doon sa Bambantarlac na Pogo?
Iniimbestigahan pa namin till now, sir, but initially, sir, yun po ang pagkakaalam namin na itong si Sun Li Ming, sir, ay involved po siya, sir, dun sa paggawa, sir, ng mga platform that were being used in scam hub, sir, dito sa atin.
Were you able to establish, Mr. Chair, the presence of this person dun sa Bamban operations?
Wala pa po kaming lumalabas sa investigasyon namin, but we are looking at that, sir. Initially, sir, we have this information, sir.
Now, Mr. Chair, paano nyo natuntun itong Chinese national dun sa Baguio? Was there a tip or talagang through intelligence work lang to? Paano, bakit nyo natuntun? Ba't nyo naisipan na nandun nagtatago itong dalawang to?
May information po kaming nakuha, sir. Yes, sir.
So, I understand na nagtatago sa isang bahay. I think Pine sa subdivision, or a certain Royal Pine subdivision ang pangalan. Sino po may-ari nung bahay?
Naku, yan na.
Sa ngayon po, sir, as yun nabanggit po kahapon, it's a property, a corporate property. I think it was owned by Mr. Harry Roque. It's a corporate property being leased by this Chinese national.
So it's owned by corporation. The house is owned by a corporation, and in turn, the corporation is also owned by, or rather, it shows that the owner of the said corporation is former Secretary Harry Roque.
Yun po yung nakita namin sa hearing yesterday, in the Senate hearing, sir.
Do you have the incorporation papers, or do we have a copy of the title of the house to prove that Secretary Harry Roque is indeed the owner of the said house?
Wala po kaming dokumento as of today, sir.
So more or less, we are assuming that yes, it's owned.
Yes, sir.
Paano po lumabas yung pangalan ni si former Secretary Harry Roque when we do not have any evidences linking Secretary Harry Roque to the said house?
As to the information kung bakit lumabas po yung pangalan ni Mr. Harry Roque, is hindi po sa amin, sir, nanggaling. Siguro po, sir, may mga nagtanong-tanong po doon if whether kung nakikita po nila si Mr. Harry Roque doon o former spokesperson Harry Roque. So, hindi na po namin alam, sir, kung saan ang galing information.
Mr. Chair, can we do some diligence work on this matter, because this is very important to establish whether that it is the house is truly owned by Secretary Harry Roque. Can we send some people to the register or to the local government unit to ask for documents, titles, and of course to the SEC regarding the corporation, the corporate papers linking Secretary Harry Roque to the said house? Kailangan siguro natin yun. Can we do that?
Yes, sir. We can have our investigation.
To former Secretary Harry Roque, well, you just have heard the statement of Yusik Gilbert Cruz that linking you to the said Chinese nationals. Kilala niyo po ba itong dalawang tao na nahuli ng PAO?
Ang hindi ko po kakilala itong dalawang tao. In fact, yung isa, sabi naman po ni Yusik, ay kakarating lang na bansa ng July, yung babae. Yung isa, pagpapakilala niya, ay siya ay Cambodian, no? So, hindi ko po kilala kung sino yung Cambodian na yan. Pero actually, Manong Johnny, just to facilitate things, inaamin ko po that I have an interest in the corporation that owns the house. Hindi ko naman po dininay ito sa Senado. Ang problema lang po talaga is we're in the process of distributing property within the family. And right now, hindi po sa akin talaga yung property. But nagkasundo po kami na talagang I want to retain this property. So ngayon po, ang nag-aari ng property ay, sandali po, kunin ko lang yung pangalan, ha? At,
so, former Secretary Harry Roque, you admit that you have an interest in this house by virtue of the corporation owning this house.
Yes po, ang may registered owner po nito is Page 2, Lot 37, Pinewood Holdings Incorporated. In turn, it is owned by a holding corporation called Biancham. Now, ang totoo po nito, I will have no more interest in Biancham, according to our organization, but I will have full interest in PH2 Lot 37 Pinewood Holdings as part of our division, no, within the holding corporation. Pero ang punto po is, meron po kaming contract of lease na ang pumintma po ay isang babae. Ang pangalan po niya ay Yun Wan. At ito po ay dated January 15, 2024. At dun po sa pirmahan ng contract of lease na notaryado, pinresenta po niya ang kanyang passport at rinequire din po siya na magpresenta ng alien certificate of registration para patunay na legal po siya sa Pilipinas. And I would like to submit a copy of this contract of lease to this body. And likewise, I don't think you have a copy of my contract of lease yet, so I will also provide this with to the PAOK, no? So para lang pong malinaw na dahil siya po ay naka-lease, hindi po ako naka-position dito.
Sino pero, po Mr. Roque ang pumirma dun sa lease, contract of lease?
Ang pumirma po ay ang aking may bahay na si Milo Roque.
So you are aware of this contract of lease?
I'm aware of this contract of lease. with this woman po, no? At ako nga po ang nagsabi na...
But you have never met this person.
I've met her po.
Ah, so...
I met her.
Kasi fact, kanina po, Mr. Roque, when I asked you, sabi niyo po, hindi niyo kilala.
But hindi now po, yung lalaki po. Yung lalaki
but now you're
Cambodian.
Telling this committee na namit mamam pala
yung lesi po.
Yung lesi po.
Namit po. In fact, hindi ko lang po namit. May isang beses pa na nag-lunch kami sa Los Angeles. No? So, wala naman po akong kaduda-duda na siya ay legitimo. Siya ay extensively traveled at meron naman siyang ACR. Sa katunayan, she wants to be in complete compliance with the law. Kaya po ngayon, nung napaso ang kanyang ACR, umalis siya ng bansa at ang sabi niya sa akin, she's in the process of renewing her ACR. Pero ang tingin ko naging problema po rito ay itong babaeng ito na may alien certificate of registration at merong passport, ang nakalagay po sa kanya, single. So ngayon po, nagtataka ako kung ano talaga ang relasyon nila doon sa lalaki na nahanap sa aking bahay, no? At nung nahanap nga po yung lalaki sa aking bahay, ito nga pong si Ana, no? Ang tawag ko sa kanya, Ana, kasi yun yung American name niya, hinanap po. At sabi ko, sino yan? Well, yun nga po, lumalabas na yung Cambodian pala ay isang partner niya, pero ang hindi ko naman alam, hindi sila kasal, ewan ko talaga kung talaga siya ay nananatili doon. Pero meron po akong katiwala doon. Kasi po, natakot ako na kapag pinaupahan ko sa incheck, sa Chino, sorry po, for the derogatory word. Minsan po kasi, nung ako ay nasa gobyerno, nagreklamo sa akin yung mga residente na isang subdivision sa Parañaque, trinifer ko sa OIC na NBI, at ginagamit daw isang residential house, bilang Pogo. So, para nga po maiwasan na maging nagamitin ito for any other purpose, hindi ko po pinaalis yung katiwala ko doon. Sa labas lang sila ng bahay, nag-aalaga ng hardin, nag-aalaga ng baka, at pinamamasbanan ko po kung ilan talaga ang pumapasok sa bahay. At ang sabi naman po nila, 3-4 lang po ang talagang nag-i-stay sa bahay. At wala.
Mr. Roque, kailan ho niyo nakilala itong lesi ninyo?
Well, actually ako po, na-meet ko siya sa LA, kailan lang po. Tapos na-meet ko rin siya nung simula po, no?
Mr. Chair, na-meet mo yung lesi, nasa LA ka?
Ay, hindi po. Nag-lunch kami sa LA.
Okay.
Nag-lunch po kami sa LA.
When you met this person, this lesi, meron ng existing contract of lease o wala pa?
Ah, meron na po. Kaya ako po siya kakilala.
Kailan po nag-start yung contract of lease ninyo?
Ang date po dito ay January 15, 2024 po itong hawak kong contract.
So prior to the signing of the lease contract, you never knew this person?
Yung lalaki po. Pero yung babae, kilala ko na rin.
Ah, matagal na kung kilala
ko. Kakilala ko na rin po yung babae. Pero ang contract of lease po niya is January 15, 2024.
January 2024 yung contract of lease. So, kailan na ho nyo nakilala itong taon to?
Hindi naman po matagal. Kailan lang din po. Hindi ko lang po maalala talaga kung kailan. Pero kasi, matagal na nilang gusto i-lease yung property. Ang balita
sino
ako dun
sa... Sino po ang nagrekomenda sa inyo itong person na ito?
Well, sila po'y talagang mapursige na gusto nilang umupa. Ako, nung una, ayaw ko talaga kasi gustong-gusto ko po yung bahay ko, no? At palagi po ako dun sa lugar na yon, no? Pero, nagpupumilit at ang nangyari, ako naman po ay nandito na sa Manila. Sabi ko, sayang naman, nabubulok. Sige, paupahan na, no? So, ito po, isasubmit ko po yung aking contract of lease.
Yes, please do. Okay. Pero Mr. Chair...
Vice Chair, can we also have the copies of those, Secretary Roque, yung incorporators? You said a while ago that there is a corporation.
Opo.
Can you kindly submit also to the committee?
Hindi ko po dala, but I can of course submit it.
No? All right, thank you so much. Okay. Go ahead.
Mr. Chair, please submit it, Mr. Roque, no? So it has been established, Mr. Chair, as per, of course, the admission of Mr. Roque, that he truly owns the house, no? Kasi hindi ka naman magpapalis. You're the one who signed the contract of lease.
Well, we have yung an interest in the corporation po. Yung wife ko po,
but
hindi ko po tinatanggi
admitted,
naman yan,
you're, no? You already admitted earlier that by virtue
po,
of your owning the corporation,
yes,
which owned the house, so literally... kayo po may-ari noon. Now,
well,
my question is, Mr. Roque, since kayo naman ang may-ari noon, pinupuntahan din naman ninyo yon. I'm very sure, according to Mr. Cruz, dun sa mga neighborhood, nakikita po yung presence ninyo. Did you not do any due diligence getting the background of this lessee?
I did po by asking for the alien certificate of registration.
Hindi po ninyo tinanong kung saan negosyo, ano ba negosyo nila?
Well,
because it seems that very clear, kaya hinuli yan, i-involve talaga sa illegal pogo.
Ay, hindi po. Hinuli po yan at ako po yung nakipag-ugnayan na sa Chinese Embassy rin dahil may wanted pala siya for financial fraud. Hindi po sa pogo. So, malinaw po yun, no? At napahiya nga po ako sa Chinese Embassy dahil ako yung malapit naman sa kanila, no? At in-explain ko rin na wala akong inalaman na meron palang pugante sa China na ninirahan dun sa bahay na yon, no? Pero malinaw naman po na sabi po sa akin ng embassy, kaya nga po siya nasa lagay sa red list ng Interpol, it's because of financial fraud. I think it is P2P in fact. Hindi ko nga alam po ano yung P2P, no? Pero P2P